As we've entered this period of social distancing and stay at home, a lot of people are experiencing the loneliness and the anxiety and some depression as well. So people who have already been experiencing depression and anxiety, that has really sort of ramped up. The beautiful thing is we have the technology now, because Zoom or FaceTime or call, while it's not in-person type interactions, banking on those gifts of technology is the best way to do that. There's all kinds of telehealth options. It's not the same as going to see your therapist, but it definitely is, you know, good contact and a good reminder, and you can continue to work on all the goals that you were working on before without the interruption. Go outside. Go outside. Go get some vitamin D. Turn off the TV. Get out of the four walls that you're in and enjoy everything that, you know, that Arizona has to offer. We should all be implementing really as much structure as we can to be as close to normal as we can. So get up, take a shower, get dressed, you know, get your kids dressed, do your homeschooling, do your work, you know, have your little home office, create a little space for that. All the things that we normally do, if you can somewhat create some level of structure similar to that, then I think that's the best thing to do. When you get stuck in that mode of channel surfing in your PJs all day long, your brain is not being stimulated, and it's really bad for your mental health. This is a process we're starting to finish. I think a lot of us who get overwhelmed need to be reminded we're in a marathon, and it definitely is a marathon. It's not a sprint, but this is not forever and ever.